please the Lord, but you don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this, the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lift, the baffled king composing hallelujah. Hallelujah.
grace poured out to us in your Son, Jesus Christ. And what wonderful promises you have given us, Lord, of eternal life, of a home prepared for us in your presence. And God, as we come to honor Warren's life, Lord, we thank you that he is seeing you face to face, that he is in your presence. Lord, you are the God of all comfort. You are the God of all hope. You are the God of love. And Father, we thank you that you have steadied and poured into Warren's life all these years, and that you have called him to yourself, Father, not only in faith here, but now, Lord, in glory. And Father, we pray for Alan, we pray especially for Helen, we pray for the family. Father, that your continuing grace would bring comfort and hope. Lord, that you would pour your love into their hearts every day and give them strength and wisdom and your blessing. Father, I don't know how to paint a picture of heaven, but the beauty of the things that Warren saw when he would paint, Lord, we stand in awe and in worship as we think of the wonders and the splendors of who you are, and what it might be like in your presence even right now. And I pray that a taste of the truth of what is awaiting us in glory, Lord, would be released into our lives now by the presence of your Holy Spirit. We thank you. We praise you for the forgiveness that we have in Christ. We thank you and we worship you for the righteousness that is given to us as a gift in Christ. And we praise you and we thank you for the assurance of eternity in your presence through the power of the resurrection. So now, Lord, bless and keep Helen and Alan and the family, each one of us in these churches, Lord, who love you and have loved Warren, Lord, that we may serve you in the grace and the power of your word. For we pray in Jesus' name. Amen. You may be seated.
约翰福音十四章一到六节，耶稣说：“你们心里不要忧愁，你们信上帝，也当信我。在我父的家里有许多住处，若是没有，我就早已告诉你们了。我去原是为你们预备地方去。我若去为你们预备了地方，就必再来接你们到我那里去。我在那里，叫你们也在那里。我往那里去，你们知道，那条路你们也知道。”多马对他说：“主啊，我们不知道你往那里去，怎么知道那条路呢？”耶稣说：“我就是道路、真理、生命，若不借着我，没有人能到父那里去。”约翰福音十四章二十七节，耶稣说：“我留下平安给你们，我将我的平安赐给你们，我所赐的不像世人所赐的，你们心里不要忧愁，也不要胆怯。”
But as Christians, as we face death, we still have peace. And this is the peace from the promise of Jesus. He said, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you." I do not give you as the world gives. Do not let your hearts be troubled and do not be afraid. And what kind of peace is peace from Jesus? And that is a peace that transcends death. And it's kind of like a peace that you're in when you are in deep sleep. It's popular these days to buy life insurance. Life insurance may provide you some guarantee of your living expenses. But it doesn't guarantee life. And when the insured dies, the insurance company pays you back in money, not in life.
And the money can help you with the remaining living expenses. But it doesn't resolve the issue of life. The peace from Jesus is one that solves eternal life. And it's a light, it's a peace that will transcend death. Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. The one who believes in me will live even though they die. Those who believe in Jesus as they come to the end of their life, they will rest in the bosom of Jesus. And those who went to sleep in the Lord will be arise.
And
the one who is resurrected will be more spirited, more lively, and stronger.
葉春祥弟兄因为生命的缘故，他最近几年行动都不太方便。
Brother Yap, because of his disease, he was immobile for the last couple of years.
而且身体越来越弱。
And his body weakened over time.
现在他安息在主的怀中。
And now he's resting in the bosom of Jesus.
他睡觉了。
And he went to sleep.
圣经告诉我们。
The Bible said,
有一天他的荣美的身体要复活。
That our bodies will be raised in glory. They are buried in weakness, but they will be raised. But they will be raised in strength. As Christians, if we die, we will be resurrected. Because the Lord Jesus that we believe is one who has been resurrected. And those who believe in him will also be resurrected. This is the reason why, as Christians, when we face death, we still have peace. The second is that this peace is one that reconciles with God. And it is a peace like when you return home. Those of you who travel, you'll have this kind of feeling that you are most at ease when you're at home. Even though we stay in luxurious hotels during our trip, but it cannot compare to the comforts of home. The restaurants during the trip may be very exquisite, but there's nothing that compares to the taste of home cooking. And this world gives you the peace like when you travel. It'll let you have a good time and make you happy. But this world cannot provide you the feeling of peace like returning home. Saint Augustine said that the human heart is restless until it finds its rest in God. A Chinese philosopher, Lin Yutang, he was dedicated to East and West philosophies. The way he described himself is that he straddles between East and West cultures, and he promotes and dedicates himself to the promotion, the understanding of philosophies from history as well as today. He was very learned. And in his old age, he said, my life is like a boat floating in the vast ocean. And it was when I come to believe and trust in God that I returned to the dock. Brother Yap has traveled many places in his lifetime. He has experienced the ups and downs of life. And today he returned home. He returned to the heavenly home. And all friends and family here, we know that. We will all come to the end of our lives. One day we will leave this world. Where will you go that day? You will return home. Do you have this guarantee? Jesus said, I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me. If any of you have not yet believed in Jesus, I urge you to seriously consider. And I believe that this is the expectation of our brother Yap. That you will reconcile with God. That you will trust in Him. So that one day you will go home. The third is that the peace is from the reunions that we have. That the peace, knowing that we can reunite. Every time we leave, we say goodbye or see you soon. But do we have this guarantee that we'll see each other again? We know that airplanes have an easier time ascending. And however, there's no guarantee that we'll descend. And every time we say see you again, is that a guarantee that we will see each other again? But in Jesus Christ, we will see each other again. The Bible said, For the Lord Himself will come down from heaven with the voice of the archangel and with the trumpet call of God. And the dead in Christ will be raised first. After that, we who are still alive and are left will be caught up together with them in the clouds to meet the Lord in the air. And so we will be with the Lord forever. In 1998, our church short-term mission went to Switzerland for the first time. And we spread the gospel to Chinese living in Switzerland. We met many brothers and sisters, the Chinese-speaking brothers and sisters in Switzerland. The French-speaking Chinese brothers and sisters. They're French-speaking Swiss living in Switzerland. They love the Lord and they're very eager. And they care about the gospel work amongst the Chinese. And so we worked together for about 2 weeks and has left deep memories in the hearts. And as we depart, an elderly Swiss sister said in English to us, we shall see each other in heaven. She knew that on this earth we may not see each other again. But in heaven we will see each other again. Today we say goodbye to our brother Yap. But we know one day in heaven we will see him again. And as we think about this, we have peace. And we have joy. Last few years, Brother Yap was immobile. His wife helped him with his daily living. Helen's a very dedicated wife. And I said to her, you took care of your husband and it took a lot of you the last few years. She said, it wasn't so bad. Warren was very easy to take care of. He never throws a temper. Whatever you give him, he accepts. This describe the respect of the wife for the husband. And it also demonstrated Brother Yap's easygoing nature and gentleness. Our Brother Yap is a respectful elder. And I hope that I will see him again soon. And I also think that he looks forward to seeing us again in heaven. Please let the Lord grant you peace. The peace from our Lord Jesus. Amen.
Since I found in him a friend so strong and true, I would tell you how he changed my life completely. He did something that no other friend could do. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one else could take the sin and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cared for me. All my life was full of sin when Jesus found me. All my heart was full of misery and woe. Jesus placed his strong and loving arms around me, and he led me in the way I ought to go. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so strong as he. No one else could take the sin and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cared for me. To me with new assurance. More and more I understand his words of love. But I'll never know just why he came to save me till someday I see his blessed face above. No one ever cared for me like Jesus. There's no other friend so kind as he. No one else could take the sin and darkness from me. Oh, how much he cared for me. She cared for me. My name is Jeffrey Yap. I'm his oldest nephew from Singapore. Of my uncle's preparation to leave us to be with his Lord was not unexpected. It was his timing and suddenness to take leave that surprised us all.
我是葉茂良, 来自新加坡, 是叔叔最年长的侄儿。 叔叔会离我们而去, 与上帝同在, 不令人意外。 但他提前突然的离去, 仍然是给我们带来的惊讶。
It was not long before, on February the 7th, last month, that I had a video conversation with my aunt, with my uncle beside her.
and on the 22nd of February, sorry, 21st of February, when he was in the hospital, we had another video chat together with my aunt and Ellen, who rushed back from New York. Uncle was able to wave goodbye to me when we ended the chat. We all felt that he would stay on for another week or two. His departure 2 hours later seemed so soon.
不久前，在2月7号，我和叔叔及婶婶还有一段私讯。2月21号，当叔叔在医院的时候，瑞明已经从纽约回到家里。我和他们也有一段私讯。当我们闲聊之后，叔叔还跟我挥挥手说再见。那时候我们都觉得他大概还有一个星期或者是更长的时间，但是2个小时之后，叔叔离开了。
Both my sisters, Jenny and Mimi, and my brother, Taiwan, and all our cousins has always have great affection for Uncle Warren with fond memories of him. When we were much younger, kids then, we were all very proud to tell our friends in Singapore and Indonesia of our uncle who lived in the United States on the beautiful islands of Hawaii. He was this very cool and relaxed guy, funny, cheeky, kind of soft-spoken, and used to regale us with his stories sometime when he was studying in Taiwan, and also working in Vietnam during the war.
回忆叔叔很多的事情，他对我们弟兄姐妹及堂兄弟姐妹都有很大的影响。在我们还很小的时候， 我们都会很得意地告诉我们在新加坡和印尼的朋友，我们有一位叔叔住在美国美丽的一个小岛夏威夷。叔叔又酷又令人放松，他非常有趣、良善，又温柔地对我们诉说他在台湾的学习，以及在越战期间在越南的工作。
We remember many years back. When on transit to Medan, Indonesia,
he stopped over
in Singapore and stayed with us in our tiny apartment. The weather in Singapore was extremely warm and humid, and he was in the living room topless. When news came around that the member of parliament for our area was visiting the electorate, including us, we told Uncle Warren, and he quickly grabbed a singlet and put it on without realizing he was wearing it inside out, the label showing. There was no time to switch around the singlet, and he had to shake the MP's hand, pretending to be a supportive citizen. It was so funny. We tried hard not to laugh. It did not escape the eyes of the MP, and as he pointed out to Uncle, he shrugged his shoulder and grinned broadly. After the MP and his entourage left, we all had a good laugh. It was so funny, we can never forget this incident.
记得多年以前，在他回印尼棉兰的途中停留新加坡，住在我们家。那时候新加坡的气候非常的温暖潮湿，他当时在家打着赤膊，忽然听说新加坡的国会议员要来造访我们这个选区。 以及我们这栋所住的公寓，叔叔立刻穿上一件，标签还露在外面，还来不及拆下的一个衬衫，然后还上前握着这个国会议员的手说：“我也是你的支持者。”太有趣了，当时我们都忍住了笑，但是这位国会议员还是看出来了，而且直接了当识破了叔叔。但叔叔却耸耸肩，毫不在乎的露齿而笑。 等到议员和他的随员都离开之后，我们都大声而笑。这件事太有趣了，我们永远忘不了这个插曲。We
remember how well Uncle paints and sketches. Such a thrill to see his pencil transform lines into beautiful portraits.
我们记得叔叔的绘画及素描都非常的棒。我们看到他用铅笔将一些线条转变为一幅非常美丽的肖像，真是令人兴奋。
In the year 2007, I brought my family to visit Uncle Warren, Aunt Helen and Ellen, and to spend the Christmas with them. My three daughters, who love art, were simply excited to meet him and to view his sketches. They also found him funny and exclaimed that the joke I made was similar to those of Uncle. In 2007, my girls thought we were funny. Now they think our jokes were lame.
2007年的时候，和家人拜访叔叔家，和他们一起过圣诞节。我的三个女儿都很喜欢美术，那次女儿们都很兴奋地见到了叔公，并且观赏了叔公的素描。他们也发现叔公非常有趣，并且大声地开玩笑说：“我们也要和叔公一样。”当年女儿们认为有趣的，现在都过去了。
Uncle Warren was both kind and generous.Over the years, me, my family, both my sisters, and my mom have visited him in Hawaii. Auntie Helen and Ellen and enjoy his hospitality. He took us to Hana Uma Bay, the Bali Lookout, and Chinese Garden to see koi.
叔叔仁慈，而且非常的大方。过去这些年，我母亲、我妹妹和我们家都到夏威夷接受了叔叔殷勤的招待，他带我们到恐龙湾、到大风口，还到中国公园看锦鲤鱼。
To Uncle Warren, family ties were so very important. He was very close to my dad and his sisters. When he was able to, he bought for his sisters and my grandmother a house in Medan, Indonesia. He helped my aunt Benny to obtain a green card.So that when she got older, she could have the option to move to Hawaii to live close to him and his family. I'm also very grateful to him for looking after my brother, Lionel, when he was studying in Hawaii.
叔叔觉得家人之间的关系非常重要，他和我父亲以及我的姑姑都非常的亲近。当叔叔有能力的时候，他为他的母亲和姐姐在印尼棉兰买了一间房子，叔叔也为淑珍姑姑申请了绿卡，使得淑珍姑姑在晚年的时候可以移居夏威夷和叔叔一家住在一起。我也非常感谢我弟弟茂福在夏威夷读书的时候，叔叔对他的照顾。
He's the last of his sibling to embark on his journey to a better place. I pray that he will continue to protect and watch over my aunt and Ellen.
叔叔是兄弟姐妹中最后一位踏上旅程的，去到了一个更美好的地方。我祈祷叔叔持续的保护看顾百灵婶婶及瑞宁堂弟。
Once again, I thank you all for your kindness to share with us this moment of our griefs.And our joy that he's now with his Lord. And soon to be united with my father, Tjhoen Siong, my aunt Benny, Amy, and my mom, Yen Moy. We shall all miss him and them so very, very much.
再一次感谢各位的仁慈，陪伴我们度过这悲伤的一刻。并且庆幸叔叔现在已经与主同在，很快的，叔叔将与我的父母、我的姑姑们同在一起，我们非常非常怀念他们。谢谢各位。
Thank you,
God. Life is just a stepping stone, a pause before we make it home, a simple place to rest and be until we reach eternity.Everyone has a life journey, a path to take with tons and lots to see. God guides our steps along the way, but we were never meant to stay.
在永恒之中，人的一生与之相比，仅仅是一个踏脚石。我们得以短暂的歇息。人生旅途如同在一条道路上观景，上帝引导我们每一个脚步。但我们都无法驻留。
Our final destination is a place filled with love, His Majesty, and grace. Today we celebrate the life of a loved one who has gone before us, the race he has won. His journey has now ended, his spirit has ascended, claiming the great reward with Jesus our Lord.
人生终站，充满了神的爱、荣耀及恩慈。今天我们再次庆贺我们所爱的，他已先我们而去，当跑的路已经跑尽，旅程已经结束，他的灵魂攀升，与主同得荣耀的奖赏。
My father was older than most when I came into this world. I never let this fact bother me when I was growing up. I was only when people asked if the man that came to pick me up every day after school was my grandpa that I would yet again be reminded of a larger than usual age difference between us. However, I always saw this as an advantage rather than a disadvantage.
我父亲是老来得子。求学期间，他每次来学校接我放学，别人总以为他是我爷爷，这常提醒了我和他之间年龄的差距。但是我总是正面的看待这件事情，他从来不成为我的困扰。
The older you become, the more life experiences you gain. I remember my father sharing with me stories from his past, such as when he was a boy during World War II and the occupation of his hometown by the Imperial Japanese Army.About being fortunate to be the first in his family to attend university. He would reminisce about the times of his life in Saigon during the height of the Vietnam War. And he would talk about his adjustment to America after immigrating to the United States.
一个人年纪越长，他的经验也越多。父亲常常和我分享他过去的故事，例如二战期间，父亲还年少的时候，日本人占领了他的家乡。他如何幸运地成为他的家族里面第一个进入大学的孩子？他也聊过越战期间他的单身岁月多么的有趣，以及移民美国之后他如何调整自己，适应美国的生活。
Many of my father's stories were interesting. Also amusing to learn from his life experiences was by not repeating his same mistakes. These would include.Taking your personal laundry to the dry cleaners because they clean your clothes. Unplugging the refrigerator before heading to work every day. Purchasing a car before learning how to properly drive.
父亲的故事非常有趣，这些令人发笑的事包括了第一，美国的干洗店不洗内衣裤，但是他不知道，他就把他内衣裤拿到干洗店去清洗了。第二，每天我们上班的时候，上班之前我们都要把冷气、把电扇、把灯关掉，但是呢，他就把那个冰箱的插头给它拔掉，因为他为了要省电。第三，他还没有学会开车，他就先买了一部车，准备在那里。
My father was a considerate man, and he had the best intentions for people.He always wanted the best for me. It was not until I got older that I started to appreciate the wisdom my father tried to instill in me. Oftentimes I was too stubborn to listen to his advice and wanted to figure things out my own way. There were also times when I was a very disrespectful son. Now that I look back, I realize my father and I have different personalities. We were not enemies, but we were also notthe greatest of friends. The two of us would disagree on many subjects, and religion would be one of these.
父亲是位体贴善解人意的人，他总是给我最好的。在我还未意识到何谓智慧的时候，他就灌输我智慧的观念。那时我还是个无理的孩子，常常坚持己见，而且顽固地不听他的劝告。如今回想起来，我和我父亲个性不同。在很多事情上我们意见不一，在信仰上也是如此。
Why should I go to church if God is all around us? My father would respond when I once asked his reason for not attending Sunday service. I believe in God. God is in my heart and I can worship him there. God gave me the chance to come to America. God allowed me to buy a house. I thank God for giving me everything up to this point in life, he would say. But for many years, my father avoided becoming a true Christian, and I wonder when and if he would ever have a change of heart. I recall praying for him on this issue, eventually replacing this particular prayer subject with others as time wore on and it appeared nothing would ever change.
以前当我问父亲为什么去教堂敬拜上帝，父亲总是说上帝无所不在啊，我干嘛一定要去教堂？父亲也说我相信上帝，上帝在我心里，我可以敬拜他。我谢谢上帝给我机会来到了美国，上帝也让我买了一间房，上帝在我人生的每一个时刻供应了我一切。 多年后，父亲虽然成为了一位基督徒，但是我总不明白他的心意没有改变，怎么就成了一位基督徒呢？我常为此向神祷告，但最后我终于放弃了这个挑剔的祷告，因为这样的祷告并不能改变什么。As
my father's health declined in recent years, my mother made an effort to bring him to church weekly. While at church, I do not know if any of the Bible readings or any of the sermons had any impact on altering his outlook on Christianity. But what I do know is that he felt the warmth of church members, of people that would come to greet him and sometimes engage in small talk. Perhaps this made a difference 3 years ago when I received the pleasant news that my father was going to be baptized at the age of 80.
近年来父亲体力衰弱，母亲每周都带他去教堂，这件事带来了果效。我不知道是否因为阅读圣经，或者是 主日讲台的信息改变了他对基督信仰的观点，但可以确定的是，教会弟兄姊妹的问候以及跟他交通，使他感受到了会员会友之间的温暖。在这3年中，有了一个不一样的结果。父亲80岁的时候，我收到了一个令人喜悦而且兴奋的消息：父亲受洗，归入主名了。What
made you change your mind? Why did you get to get baptized now? I later asked him. He paused for a moment and then replied, "Everything is stable now. All is well."
我之后曾问他是什么改变了你的心意，并且决定受洗了呢？父亲停下一会儿，思索了一下，回答我说：“现在一切都平静安稳，一切都是这么美好。”My
father is right. Everything is stable now that he found salvation and is in the presence of the Lord. All is well.
父亲是对的，他已经得着基督里的救恩，现在一切都已平静安稳，一切都是这么美好。On
behalf of the Yap family, I want to thank everyone for attending my father's memorial service. Thank you for your friendship. Thank you for being part of his celebration of life. Please join us on the second floor afterwards for some refreshment and conversation.
最后，谢谢各位长辈及弟兄姊妹来参加父亲的安息礼拜，谢谢你们的情谊，谢谢你们给了父亲一个人生的祝贺。我们在二楼预备了一些茶点，欢迎你来参加，一起享用。
I give you all. I give you all. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.